Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. So today we have a topic with us. It's called the absolute function, that is the ABS function in Excel. Now how we are going to go towards this thing, we'll study in a detailed format. First and the foremost thing, the ABS function in Excel, it gives the absolute value. It gives the absolute value of a number. Okay. It always returns a positive number, and it is built-in function in Excel and is categorized as a math and a trig function. It is categorized as the math and the trig function. Now, how does the ABS formula works in Excel? See, the argument used in ABS formula in Excel goes something like this. If you just write ABS, it returns the absolute value of a number and a number without any of its sign. So it's just has number as the argument, the number which you want to calculate the absolute value in Excel. So in the above function of ABS, the number can be given as directed in quotes or as cell references. It can be entered as a part of the ABS formula in Excel. So it can be a mathematical operations giving a number as an output. And in the function of ABS, if the supplied number argument is non-numeric, it gives a value error. So how does the output work? See, on the output end, an ABS in Excel returns the absolute value of a given number, and the absolute value of a number in is the number excluding the sign. Thus, the positive numbers remain unchanged. Okay. Now, how does the absolute value in Excel it works? See, suppose you want an absolute value of a number, let's say -10.5. Okay. So, in the function of ABS, the number is also given in cell B4 here. Okay, so you can enter the absolute value in Excel as is equal to ABS, this number that you select that gives us 10.5. So you can enter the absolute value in Excel as ABS and as shown here. And this will return to 10.5. Now, alternatively, you can also enter an absolute value in Excel as is equal to ABS absolute -10.5. Just write that and it will automatically convert that. Now, in the function of ABS, this will also return in the same value. Now, in the function of ABS, the number can also be entered in the quote as is equal to ABS in comma -10.5 close the bracket. Again, it will return to 10.5. So, in the function of ABS, it may also return the value in the Excel as 10.5. So, suppose cell B6 here is 10.5, and you want to see that what would be the output of the ABS function Excel when this is given as an argument. So upon giving either of the formula, ABS formula in Excel is used something like this, is equal to ABS B6, it goes to 10.5. You can also write something like this. Rather than that, just write 10.5. It will show you the absolute answer, or else you can write in the apostrophe 10.5, close the bracket. So you will get 10.5 as the absolute value in the Excel, and the positive number remains unchanged or unaffected. First, A as input is equal to ABS B6. This is how you did, right? For all the outputs that you have written. Now, how to use this in Excel function, that's what we are going to learn here. To find absolute value in Excel, it's very simple and easy to use. Let's understand the working of ABS function Excel by some example. Suppose you have a list of this value given in B3 to B10, and you want the absolute values in Excel of this number. So how are you going to do? So for the first cell, you can type the ABS formula in Excel. Over here, ABS 5 and then Control D. Okay, so you get all the absolute value here. Once you drag all the rest of the cells, you get the absolute values in the Excel. Now, all the numbers in C3 to C3 are the absolute numbers. Example number 2. Suppose you have a revenue data over here. for the 7 departments for your company and you want to calculate the variance between the predicted and the actual numbers. How you're going to do that? Well, it's as simple as that. For the first one, you can use the AVS formula, something like this, is equal to ABS, comma, the number that is D4 minus the predicted value. Is equal to ABS D4 less E4 divide by E4. Once you do that, you get the variance, and variance will be an absolute variance. So do control D and you have the answers for all rest of them by dragging the answer. Example number 3. Now suppose you have some data in B3 to B8 here, and you want to check whether of these numbers are positive and which one is negative. So to do so, you can use the function of ABS to find the absolute value in Excel. How we are going to do that? So you can use the ABS formula in Excel, something like this. You'll start with the if function, saying if my ABS absolute value, that's B3. Okay, if this is equal to B3, okay, comma, show me positive, or else show me negative. As simple as that. Okay, if absolute is equal to value, see, this is okay, this is not in negative, this both are positive. I hope you are getting it. Example number 4. Suppose you have a list of the predicted and actual data on an experiment, and now you want to compare which of these lie within the range of the tolerance of 0.5. So the data is given is C3 to C10 that is shown here, and to check with which one are within the tolerance range, you can use the absolute formula in Excel, saying is equal to if, in if you will write ABS absolute C4 minus D4 comma less than equal to 0.5. if that's the case, accepted, comma rejected, that's gonna be the negative value, close the bracket, and there we go. Just press control D and you have all the answers. If the difference between the actual predicted if less than 0.5, it is accepted, else it is gonna be rejected. So this has a difference more than that, and so do the rest. Well, similarly, you can do for all rest of them. You'll move on with the last example. Suppose you have a list of the numbers and you want to calculate the closest even number for the given numbers. Well, all of this data that you have right here, you can use the following ABS formula, saying is equal to if the logical test is ABS. And you can use an even formula inside this, saying this B3 less B3. If this is greater than 1, comma, use another if function, saying B3, if this is less than 0, then even is equal to B3 plus 2, comma, even. Take B3, okay, minus 2, just close the bracket and do minus 2, okay, close the bracket, say even, and the last B3, and there we go, it goes us to say that minus 4. So if even B3 is the nearest even number of B3, then absolute value, that is even B3 minus B3 is less than 1 or equal to 1. And so on and so forth. So for all the rest, you apply this formula and you will have the answer. Example number 6. Now suppose you want to identify the closest value of the list of the value to be given value. So you can do so using the absolute function in Excel. The list of the values which are given here. You want to search are provided B3 to B9, and the value of the lookup is given in cell F3. You can use the absolute formula in Excel, something like this, is equal to index B3 to B9, comma match. In that you say min, use another ABS formula saying F3 less B3 to B9, close the first one, close the second one, use ABS again saying F3 less all of this B3 to B9, comma, exact match, and that's it. So this is how you play with the numbers here and use the formula in this particular fashion. Now there are some of the things that you should remember. What are those things? The first one, the ABS function in Excel returns the absolute value in Excel, that is the modulus. Second, the function of the ABS, it converts the negative numbers to positive numbers. Third, in the function of ABS, positive numbers are unaffected. And fourth, in the function of ABS, the value error occurs if the supplied argument, if the particularly the supplied argument is non-numeric in nature. That's it. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone for joining the session.